They are expecting some severe damage.
5 or 6 hours now of heavy rain to go along with that.
Here at Salvation Army plans to serve
where there are sewage problems.
In terms of figuring out how much.
While people in Orleans Parish were still underwater and on rooftops, there was a plan being formed to take away the schools in Orleans Parish.
The public should know that the Orleans Parish School Board was pressured by the state education officials to start charter schools.
Superintendent Picard clearly stated to me and several other board members that he didn't want schools to open unless they opened as charter schools.
The state, when they took over 107 schools, did not have a plan to open the schools. Matter of fact, they didn't want to open them. Mr. Picard is quoted as saying he had no intentions of opening the regular schools. He wanted charter groups from around the country to open the school.
Of course, we found out later on that he had been working with the governor, or the governor at some point, I'm not sure if it was either October of that year, signed the executive order, which basically removed all of the kind of requirements to become a charter school in terms of community and faculty and parent vote related to that, so which made charter schools basically able to happen almost overnight.
Discussion was being had by several BESSE members led by Leslie Jacobs on how can we take the schools? How can we get this district that's now on its knees scrambling to stay alive and kill it? Just kill it, the coup de grace. We have finally got an opening that would have taken us 40 or 50 years of back and forth and forth and back. It has been handed to us. How do we do that? Well, declare the district an academic crisis.
In the state capitol, there was another law being passed called Act 35.
17 days in November. At first, we all thought that the 17-day session was going to be reconstruction of New Orleans, housing, and things like that. When it became set with the takeover, complete takeover of the New Orleans school system and readjusting existing law that would only be targeted at New Orleans, then you saw it was something totally different.
The dirty deed in Act 35 is that the state changed the definition of what a failing school was so that it would bring in more schools than it had ever brought into the recovery school district.
No longer was a failing school with a performance score less than 60. A failing school got to be a school with a performance score less than the state average of 87.4. It definitely targeted New Orleans. I mean, it targeted New Orleans. New Orleans was the only school system that was taken over by Act 35.
Really, it could have bankrupted the school board, because what it did was then removed the bulk of schools away from Orleans Parish School Board. And just to put it in economic terms, if we don't have the buildings, then we can't have students. And if we don't have students, then we don't have money.
The takeover was to be a massive experiment in improving the schools.
I thought the goal was to just create new schools, innovative schools that work for our children, whether they're charter schools or not. A lot of money has come into New Orleans to open up new schools. That actually incentivizes school failure. The more schools fail, the more money certain organizations can get to open new schools. They give no thought to what closing a school does to a child. Closing a school just simply starts the money changing hands again.
After 7 years and millions of dollars, and the Recovery School District of New Orleans, when you look at all the school districts, is at the bottom, just like the New Orleans Public School District was at the bottom. on the date of the hurricane, August 29th, 2005.